got some questions from Facebook today. And half a dozen questions which I'll try and answer for you. The first one's from Susie. She's making a comeback after a few years off of injury and so forth. Best way to do it? Go to a practice putting green, have a few putts, have a few chips. Get into the swing of things, go and play a few holes if you think you're up to it. Start off with your 3 wood or your 5 wood off the tee. Just start swinging nice and easy, don't put yourself under any pressure. Just sort of keep it nice and simple, sort of 3/4 stuff. Keep the pressure off, don't try and score. Just get out and play and sort of get acquainted with the golf course again. See how you go with that, Susie. We've got one from Bobby Toll, an old mate of mine from the bush. Bob's hitting irons thin, and also he's duffing his driver. He's sort of hitting behind the ball and smothering the ball. You haven't changed much, Bob. What's happened to you, mate? These hips are too square at impact, and this is hanging back too much. I'm exaggerating, I know, but that's you at impact, and this is what happens. That's why you hit it thin and fat. So all you need to do, mate, just get into this position. This is your impact position. Twist your hips, twist your shoulders out of the way like this, and have this little follow through like so. And go and hold that position. Go and hit a few shots and hold that position. And you'll get that golf ball back on the face again. And don't be miserable. Come down, have a lesson, and pay for it. Good golfing. Who else have I got, Monique? Now I have chipping from just off the green. This is how you chip. I'm not sure if you're a beginner or not, but you can use a lot of clubs to chip with, such as your 7-iron, 8-iron, hybrid. I'm a fan of hybrid. Chipping's like this. Set up in front of the ball. Don't set back like this. Set up in front of it. Stay on top of the shot like this. And that's a little backswing like that, and a little follow through like that. Learn to run the ball along the ground and get a little bit of touch along the ground. It'll help you a lot. So set up, feet very close together, hands in front, stay over the ball, swing it up, and then come through. That's how you do that. Give it a try. Good golfing. We have hooking the ball. We don't see many hookers. Hookers are usually the hips stop. What happens, you'll come into the shot, the hips will stop and the hand will take over. That's what happens there. So all you need to do, once again, get into the hitting area again, get into this position here like this, get these hips fired up here, and that's your little drill. The same one as Bobby Toll's, that one. I was a hooker in my day. No one hooked the ball more than what I did. And that's how you stop it, just hips out of the way and hold that finish. That'll get you going, good golfing. What else have I got? I'm a bit lost. Playing from wet sand. Let me get a sand iron. Here's one. Come this way, please, for me. When you're in wet sand, don't panic. I know the ball comes out a bit quicker. There's no big deal about it. Wet sand. Use your wedge, maybe. Not a big round and sand iron. You don't want it too bouncy, more like a wedge. And swing slow, that's all it is to it. Just swing nice and slow. That's how you do it. Just got to back yourself a little bit with that. Anyway, give it a try, good golfing.